Dear students, in this session, I am beginning from page number 151, paragraph number 2. In this paragraph, Pradeepan Pambirikunna is talking about caste questions in the writings of literary history. Let us see. Let us also examine the caste questions raised by literary histories. Ullur's exemplary Malayalam literary history is well trained in the art of detecting the caste of most writers. So in the previous paragraph there was a reference to Ullur's literary history, and according to the author, very conscious attempt is made to name the caste of the writers described in that text. Such an approach generally adopted by other literary histories also describes caste as Kerala's history and inscribes it as a sign of poetry as well. So this is one of the caste questions that the author points out. So if over importance is given to the caste of the authors, then people will think that Kerala history is full of such references to the castes. But how can caste be an important criteria in textual analysis by literary historians which simultaneously claim to espouse secularism and place themselves as being above caste, creed and religious considerations? So why caste is given so much prominence? It cannot be allowed. While writing about Ezhuthachan, why does it bother the historian whether he is a son of a Nambudiri or not? In short, apart from unearthing the caste, religion, region, father, political party, God, etc. of the author, our literary histories have not made any significant leap. So this is what Pradeepan Pambirikunna talks about as the shortcoming of the traditional literary history in Malayalam writings. They have only given prominence to this caste associations of the author, and by doing so there is a politics just to alienate the authors belonging to the so-called lower castes to the margins. Moreover, when it is a lower caste author, literary histories become contradictory, often discourteous, if not offensive. So here there is a reference to Ezhuthachan, note number 11. Usually regarded as the father of Malayalam literature, one of the greatest poets of the Bhakti movement. Adhyatma Ramayanam Kilippattu is his magnum opus. So why should we refer to such a great person in terms of his family or his father or his caste? There is no need of referring to such a person on that line. So that is the point made here clear. Now I am moving to the next paragraph. About Pandit K.P. Karuppan, Ullur observes, "Overall, his style is brilliant. Very rare are verses without merit. A highly talented poet is evident in each of his works." So K.P. Karuppan, there is a reference here, note number 12. Pandit K.P. Karuppan, his period is 1885 to 1938. He was a noted Malayalam poet, was a relentless fighter against untouchability. He had a significant role in the Renaissance in Kerala. His poetical work, Jadi Kummi, is a pioneering attempt that questioned the oppressive caste system. So, Pandit K.P. Karuppan. Now, we are going to analyze how this author is treated by different writers in the literary history of Malayalam. So about Pandit K.P. Karuppan, Ullur observes. How does Ullur observe? Overall, his style is brilliant. Very rare are verses without merit. A highly talented poet is evident in each of his works. This is how Ullur observed the writings of Pandit K.P. Karuppan. On the other hand, Leelavathi judges Karuppan in a very negative manner. Leelavathi, who is referred to here? As we all know, it is M. Leelavathi, Malayalam literary critic. The reference is to her book, Malayala Kavitha Sahitya Charitram, History of Malayalam Poetry. So in that work, M. Leelavathi, she judges Karuppan in a very negative manner. So why does that occur? Not only does Leelavathi, who usually uses emotionally charged comparisons, become toneless in her description of Karuppan, she also belittles him as a poet who cannot lay claim to any greatness, though he has more than 10 to 20 works to his credit. So M. Leelavathi is making a very negative comment about K.P. Karuppan. So Pandit K.P. Karuppan, actually, he was a fighter against untouchability. And that was not at all acknowledged by a great writer, a historian who had written the literary history of Malayalam, that is M. Leelavathi. He is not at all acknowledged by M. Leelavathi. Though he has 10 to 20 works to his credit, Pandit K.P. Karuppan has written 10 to 20 volumes of poetry or collections of poetry, but even then he is not at all considered worth referring to by M. Leelavathi. It should be remembered that Leelavathi, in the same text, advocates literary history is not a catalogue of books. It should be able to examine the real blood connection between social life and the literary work, describe its stylistic features, offer a critical appreciation based on an in-depth analysis. So, this is a quotation from that work. According to M. Leelavathi, how literary history should be. That is a very perfect definition of literary history. It is not a catalogue of books, but it should be able to examine the real blood connection between the social life and the literary work. But she is she is unable to find out that blood connection between the author and the contemporary society. Observe how the claims of such aesthetic historical projects become hollow before Karuppan, whose poetry was a social weapon to the extent that Swadeshabhimani Ramakrishna Pillai made fun of Karuppan's poetry, saying it smelt of fish. There is a reference to another criticism faced by Pandit K.P. Karuppan. So Swadeshabhimani Ramakrishna Pillai, he was the editor of Swadeshabhimani, a journal published by the Renaissance figure Vaikam Abdul Qadir Maulavi. He is generally regarded as a progressive political activist, but his caste remark about Pandit Karuppan betrays his upper caste prejudices. So, Swadeshabhimani Ramakrishna Pillai. So, he is generally considered as a progressive political activist. But when the question of caste comes, there is a tendency for him to marginalize writers like K.P. Karuppan. And the words that he uses, Karuppan's poetry, saying it smelt of fish. The face of literary history becomes even more sullied when we understand how these same literary histories eulogized Manipravala poetry. which basically extolled the mental decadence and historical discontents of the Brahminical caste. So this is the partiality that is exposed by Pradeepan, as there is in the literary history of Malayalam. So Manipravala poetry, note number 17. Manipravalam is a separate literary language, consciously crafted by the elite of medieval Kerala. This literature was composed in a curious mixture of Sanskrit and Tamil. So this Manipravalam is considered as part of the upper caste aesthetic. So whatever be the theme analyzed in that text, that is getting extolled, that is getting praised for its merit, eulogized is getting applauded, it is applauded, it is praised. Eulogized Manipravala poetry, which basically extolled the mental decadence and historical discordance of the Brahminical caste. Moreover, a commonsensical notion of beauty and merit as a simple and self-evident attribute outside of history is unashamedly latent in all such writings. A commonsensical notion of beauty and merit, it is also not there in the literary history. So a lot of discriminations and partialities are being made in the name of caste, in the name of color, in the name of sections in society, different sections in society. So here in this session, we have analyzed how some of the writers, they perceive caste difference or the question of caste in their writings. We have seen the opinion of Ullur, how M. Leelavathi considers the writings of Pandit K.P. Karuppan, and also we saw Swadeshabhimani Ramakrishna Pillai, his attitude towards Pandit K.P. Karuppan, and how the Manipravala poetry is getting eulogized, it is getting applauded, even though its theme is something like the decadence of the historical discontents of the Brahminical caste. So this element of partiality is evident in the traditional literary history of Malayalam when we analyze it in terms of the question of caste. I wind up this session here. We will continue the chapter in the next session. Thank you.